Hi, this is Nivas from Engine Academy. Happy World Book Day. I'm happy to share something related to book on World Book Day. So this book name is called My Story. It was written by Kamala Das. She is the author. It is an autobiography of Kamala Das. This book is a translation of her original version book named Ente Kada. It was released in 1973. English version was published in 1988. And that is the copy I'm having. Okay. She is a famous Malayalam writer, Malayalam woman writer, who is known worldwide. Many people could relate with her, mostly female, who really look out for real love. Because throughout this book, throughout this autobiography, we can really feel how she is in search of true love. She had a lot of wealth, but she considered only writing as her wealth. She considered only readers as her wealth. She won several awards, including the Sahitya Akademi Award, which is given for a literature person. All her works has been translated to English, French, Spanish, Russian, and she has a worldwide following. Times called her the mother of modern English poetry because she just wrote a lot of poems. She had a natural death on May 31st, 2009. She was 75 when she passed away. Would you believe that this woman, who passed away in 2009, wrote an autobiography 40 years before? She had that much clarity, or should we call she was so much tortured to get that autobiography out of her own mind. It's one of the best books which I read. There are a total of 50 chapters in the English version. This is translated keeping in mind the English reader's thinking. Okay, so from the first 10 chapters, it is like she is starting a life with her cousins in Malabar, in a place called Nalapet House, where she is meant to grow. So she moved to Calcutta, where she is in a boarding school, where she comes across the first encounter of a lesbian. She first encounters a kiss, and she also encounters cruelty. She was very small, around 7 or 8 at that time. So all these range of emotions going through a child at 1942, and we are reading this at 2020. The things which I am talking is my point of view about this book. Many people will have different versions. So continuing the story, she got married at the age of 15, and she had a fallout marriage. She went through the brutality of sex. She had a lot of problems. She was thinking that her husband would take care she was just 15. What else would a 15-year-old think? 16 or 17, and she gave birth to a son. So think about the trauma she goes through. Okay? And he has a commitment with his work. So what she thought is, my husband doesn't have a commitment with me. So that was also mentioned in this book. Every woman needs compassion. Okay, so every woman goes in search of that. There's nothing wrong in it because every human being does that. So when you find one, that is where you feel that, okay, this is my life. But till the end of her life, she lived with her husband. I really don't understand that part. The only thing which was constant is her searching a true love. Okay? Because at that time, there were riots, there were independence struggles, she had a community problems, she had her own personal problems, but in her book, these things were just, passing clothes. The main concern for her was she finding her soulmate, but no one touched her heart. She wrote only one poem relating to her husband in this book. Okay, I want you to hear this. She writes this poem when she is on sedatives. If people could understand, she was not well, she was taken care by her husband. At that time, she writes this poem. Hear this one. On sedatives, I am more lovable, says my husband. My speech becomes a misleading terrain. The word emerges tinctured with sleep. They rise from the still curves of dreams in unhurried flight like herons. And my ragdoll limbs adjust better to his versatile lust. On sedatives, I grow more lovable, says my husband. Again, have this in mind. Says her husband, not K. Das. Okay? She lives in Calcutta, she lives in Bombay with her husband, and then finally she comes back home to Malabar, to the Nalapet house. where she spent her final life. She is writing every day, okay? It's like part of her life. And she can live only with her readers. See, the readers were a mixed bag. Some are controversial, some are really into her. And there's a one twist which I want to share. I don't know whether it's true or not, because this autobiography, as it says, is the life of a woman who searches love, and she didn't get it. That is what my thinking is. She has not been given any happiness in the physical world. So she created a home world where her husband sits on the couch. She dances with a stranger. And she comes back home and says to her husband that the stranger is trying to seduce her. Even after that, the husband was not keen on taking care of her, which means either he should be stupid or either this is a complete hallucination. Okay? She could have gone to the party with her husband, sitting with her husband the whole night, but when she started writing, she would have written that, okay, I met a handsome guy like this, and this guy tried to approach me. You should read this book to know what is feminism, to know the deep secrets of a woman, not all the secrets, but deep secrets, and to know the ups and downs a woman faces in her life. So it's a Women's Day special, so okay. And it's a coincidence that I read this book on World Book Day. So hope you get this book and know more about Kamala Das and her writings. She had written a lot of poems, she had written a lot of books, and you're lucky if you're reading this in Malayalam. Nandri.
புக்கு யாரு கொடுத்தா நீங்க கடைசி வரைக்கும் சொல்லவே இல்லீங்களே
புக்கு யாரு கொடுத்தாவா This one?
Yes.
No. This was suggested to me by a Malayali friend.
Hi. This is Aarti. She is the one who shot this video. If you do have any comments about this video, please do drop a comment. Okay? So, bye.
Bye-bye.
Nandri.
Nandri.